Okay, it is Wednesday, November 3rd, and just saying it a lot lately, what a beautiful day out here. 52 degrees, and absolutely beautiful. We seem to be in another lull before the call. I don't know, I use that term a lot, but the day after election day, and here the people that believe some external savior is going to stop all this are biting their nails, waiting to see if their candidate got in, Jack Cittarelli, and beat Phil Murphy, the guy that's for all the mandates, been doing all of this for the past 2 years. And the joke of an election this is very, very similar to the same narrative they ran in the Bush Jr. election, where it was 50-50, and oh my God, it's so close. And, you know, everybody's at home watching the results and waiting and talking and debating all day. The same thing is happening here, where, you know, they're, of course, wanting to polarize and divide everybody. So they're giving us the soap opera / reality TV star version of how they're going to do that. And of course, I'll throw in the Saturday Night Live skit because it's so damn stupid, it's not even funny, you know.
Duh.
2 months of listening to Jack Cittarelli. He wants your child to be hurt. He doesn't believe that children are susceptible. He doesn't believe in the mandates. Do you want that, you know, running your state?
Imagine a world where politics, not science, drives COVID-19 policy. Where the economy only works for the rich. Jack Cittarelli's New Jersey would only work for the wealthy and would leave the rest of us behind. We can't let Jack take us back.
Confederate flags, white supremacists, and Jack Cittarelli pushing Trump's lies.
Working hard, make sure things go our way.
They tried to make things go their way. Now Cittarelli is pushing Trump's extreme agenda.
I supported Donald Trump's policy.
And they're on every radio station. They're in the mailbox. They're on the door. They're on the internet every time you turn it on. And it's just been a joke. And now, today, those that are putting their external faith into the system that's actually doing this to us, much like those that are waiting for Trump to come back for another 3 fucking years. Enjoy that. are thinking they can vote their way out of the country. And they will soon learn that is not going to happen, you know. And of course, I didn't vote. I don't vote. Only voted once in my life when I was duped, like many of you, into voting. Into voting for all the things Trump was saying, but clearly not what he did. And it took me all of a month, a couple of weeks after he was inaugurated, to see the chemtrails in the sky triple, and another bombing of Syria, and the continued false flags and school shooting agenda, and then right up until the whole pandemic we're experiencing now with the fast-tracked miracle jabs that now, after less than a year, people have 4 of in their bodies since its release onto the world without clinical trials because of the fast-tracking. But now it's approved. now it's approved for 5-year-olds and shit, too. They said, oh, okay, good. Yeah, really? Anyway, that guy. Remember how he saved us and then set everyone up to come down and be part of a fake insurgence that was planned to implicate everyone?
I see people out there get hurt. I don't want to see you get hurt. We will make a path dead ass. We don't want to.
That's what I'm saying. We'll make a path, bro. We back. We just had to make a path. When the whole country hates us, we have to go. Let's go. Get this shit.
Fuck your Jersey elections. Fuck your, you know, presidential elections. Shove it up your bunghole, you see. That is the attitude we're supposed to be taking here, and simply not complying with our own fucking enslavement. But again, most people around here, and of course probably in the country, are hoping they can vote their way out of it because it's too scary to say no. And you know, once our guy gets in, this will all be over. Yeah, I don't think so, Tim.
I don't think so, Tim.
But, you know, enjoy that mindset because that mindset is why my freedom and my children's freedom and your freedom and your children's freedom is in jeopardy. So, you know, once we decide, because that's the only way, people have to decide themselves to see the truth and stop ignoring it, then maybe we can make a difference in what's actually going on in the world. Till then, you keep supporting their bullshit system and pretending you can vote your way out of it and thinking that it's us against them and not realizing this entire, you know, it's global. Have you looked at Australia? Have you looked at Canada, the UK, Germany? Have you looked at any of those places? Italy? Oh yeah, no, right, because that over there isn't coming here and doesn't affect you, right? So. Yeah, we'll be able to vote our way out of it. Yeah. Oh boy. So, hopefully people will at some point not fall for the banana in the tailpipe. However, they just keep doing it. I mean, endless supply of bananas with an endless bunch of people giving them their tailpipe, you know? you know, go ahead. Give me a small banana this time, right? Be a nice, good master and make the banana small. Here you go. There you go. Ooh, that wasn't so bad. See? See? This guy's not bad. I'll vote for him, you know? So, anyway, what else has been going on? Well, again, what else has been going on is just another aspect of how we get out of this mess, which is to summon the courage to actually see the truth and stop giving this narrative the spotlight and step out of it and to realize the only way out of this is non-compliance with our own enslavement. And the building of courage starts with the gaining of knowledge and then the understanding of that knowledge before you can actually start to, you know, make that knowledge actionable in the world as truth, because you need to ascertain the truth through those first two steps. You can't stop when the truth becomes too painful or too scary to learn and just hold on to that amount and then choose to go no further and then take your understanding into the world and present it as truth. Because what happens is you then support the lie, whether ignorantly or apathetically or out of pure fear and hope someone else will fix it. And that is why these elections work. They play on the minds of the cowardice in hoping that someone's gonna save them. A politician, a divine entity, an unstoppable force that's gonna wipe out the evil from the world. Yeah, you know, that unstoppable force is the creator. Do you know what that creator is? It's you and me and everybody the hell else that are creating. We are all a part of that infinite mind. And how that manifests depends on how we manifest it. No one's swooping out of the sky to fix humanity. People have come and gone teaching and being the example of truth and explaining through their words and their actions what we need to do as people. But people have been put into states of psychological stand down, waiting for that person to come back and do it for them. And so the mustering of courage that needs to be lit among people can only come from within. We can talk about it, we can demonstrate it, we can be the example of it. But until that person decides to embrace it and become it themselves, no one can do it for them. So courage starts by realizing you've been duped. Everyone's being duped right now, waiting for the result of whether or not they're gonna get the nice slave master or the evil slave master. And then go out and take it out on each other if they get the one that they didn't want. Yeah, that's a real achievement there in spiritual growth, right? As people. So, speaking of courage, I'll close out with a fun story. My daughter, of course, displaying courage in her actions much lately when it comes to much of her life lately when it comes to, you know, the turning down of scholarships to play soccer at the collegiate level after the mandation of this miracle jab came in at the very last minute. And eventually her entire academic career at the moment altogether, because after soccer went away in her second choice, even though the mandates weren't there, she realized the level of brainwashing and nonsense she was being asked to do when asked to research a topic, yet have to stay in these certain parameters when explaining her research and pertaining to this ideology that she's instructed to keep it at. You know, she's not allowed to expand upon things on the topic. And she looked at it and went, what the fuck am I doing? What is this? I just wanted to play soccer, you know? So the reality of it is she's been traveling and doing amazing things because she's young and she deserves to, while also speaking out, everywhere she goes when the lie manifests. And she actually ended up going skydiving this past weekend. There's a place like a half hour up the road from here, and she's always wanted to do it. And you want to talk about courage? Just look at this.
All right, Casey. I see you're all harnessed up there.
Yep.
What are we getting into today?
Oh, I don't know what we're getting into.
No?
Ready to jump though.
Going skydiving?
Yep.
First time?
Yep, first time.
You excited, scared,
I'm very
nervous?
Excited. I don't even know. I have butterflies everywhere. Like,
all right.
I'm ready to go.
Any last words for friends and family at home?
See ya.
High five. Let's go skydive.
All right.
All right, Casey. Oh, welcome back to Earth, girl.
That was the craziest thing ever.
Right?
Oh my God, can we go again?
Yeah? You want to go again?
I'm ready to go again.
Let's go again.
Oh my God. That was incredible.
Right?
I can't believe that was real. Oh my God, I want your job. This is awesome.
Come get it. Great job.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thanks for jumping with us here at Skydive Cross Keys.
Now, you tell me, first of all, not only how amazing that is, but as I watch her inner spirit during the entirety of it, I didn't see 1 ounce of fear. She was a little butterfly-y, fly-y in the belly. But she, of course, as you can see, enjoyed every minute. But she literally, during the entire time, the lead up to, never expressed any kind of fear, only excitement. And most people would say they don't want to do that because they don't want to go splat, you know. They're afraid of what can go wrong. My daughter don't even think about it. And upon free-falling for the first 60 seconds just in the sky, never once did she, and she said, you know, never once did I start to go, oh my God, I want this over. She loved every second of it. And summoning that kind of courage to do something like that, as I've seen the things she has done over the past months of her life, makes me proud, you know, because I know as the future goes on, that courage for life will continue to grow, and that fire and spark for freedom and truth and doing the right thing will grow and grow and grow, because watching that and thinking about how courageous she had to be to do it is inspiring to me, you know, and maybe even on another trip, because she wants to do it again, could inspire me to go with her, because it looks like something I'd love to enjoy with her. But for the meantime, I'll watch that and just smile and be completely enamored and in awe of her courage and her fire for life and her fire for freedom and truth and morality in the world, you know. Her instructor, who was wearing a mask, if you didn't notice, she turned and said to him, "Why are you wearing that thing?" You know, and he said, "Oh, it's not for the reasons you think. It's," he said, "because I jump a million times a day and I get all chapped, and especially when it's cold." She's like, "Okay, I'm just making sure," because you know, that's my daughter, you know. And the reality of it is, those times to experience that level of freedom is limited right now, whether or not people actually want to realize that or not, because we are moving into the 2.0 aspect here in this country that many other countries have already reached forward in 5.0 at, but they have to go slower here because of the weaponry everyone still possesses in this country to defend their rights from tyranny. So they have to pit us all against each other. So it's very clear to see how they're going to do that here in New Jersey with this close election, quote unquote close election. Really, you know, should have really mopped the floor with this guy, because nobody that I've ever spoken to in my life is actually a fan of Murphy's, you know. But somehow, you know, he's just, you know. And again, regardless, that is the setup to create the division that they want. And of course, the rest of it moving in with supply chain shortages and all the economic woes that are going to follow, with, you know, more and more variants of the variant and the variant and the variants that are going to come in and just make us all so vulnerable, you know, being pumped down our throats 24/7, that, you know, this is happening. This is inescapable, you know, inexcusable. What the hell is that from? I don't remember, but I'll find it.
I heard what you did in the parking lot, big boy, and it is inexcusable.
but it's inescapable, you know, because we can only turn this around by not complying with our own enslavement. And if one side of the dialectic is going to push the tyranny for the slave masters, then those that are, you know, going to remain autonomous over their own mind, body, and soul are going to defend themselves. and are not going to walk onto the trains and the camps like they did, 75, 80 years ago. It isn't going to happen.
All right, so we got it live. The worldwide walkout. Welcome to JWTV show, where we cover all the uprising and resistance against tyranny. You want to be here. We were talking about parasites that they want to use on soldiers for biological, supposedly we're going to save it from the biological weapons. No, we just need to put this genetically mutated parasite in your stomach. Follow the orders now. But anyway, and it's also the Hydras as well, as we talked about, is another issue. Just yesterday, we called out a lot of issues. If you haven't checked out this channel, remember, subscribe, click the bell notifications. We're going to let you hear what's going on here.
Best of luck to you. So if you want to see here, we're about, I would say, two-thirds of the way across the bridge. And again, if you're just tuning in, this is a fairly large protest against the vaccine mandates that have gone into effect here in New York City. All city workers need to be vaccinated in order to not lose their jobs. About 9,000 people have already been put on unpaid leave or lost their jobs due to being unvaccinated. A lot of people I spoke to here, you got teachers, FDNY, police officers, and what's interesting, you have vaccinated and unvaccinated people here, because most of the people are against the mandate.
And these are things that we need to accept so that we can prepare ourselves for them mentally, physically, emotionally, psychologically, come out, enter into this knowing why, and come out, if we come out, on the other end of this, free. Because if we don't come out, you and I or anybody else standing up for freedom, we are hoping that our actions can continue to be emulated and freedom will still manifest. Whether or not we are here to enjoy that freedom, in the end, it makes no difference right now, because without the front line manifesting this stance against tyranny, it ain't gonna happen. And right now, most people are in stand down mode. Whether we want to realize the world's waking up and we're in a new age aspect of free, it's all, we just got to go through a bumpy ride first. Oh yeah, it's a bumpy ride, and it's a bumpy ride that you have to partake in, that you are going to have to choose whether or not you stand for freedom, for everyone's freedom, by your actions and your words and your deeds. This is the result of years of ignoring what has been cultivating for decades. And this is the last chance. Well, there's my alarm, but I gotta head back because I gotta pick up my son. So we're gonna cut it there. And we'll see if we can get this up tonight, hopefully. But these are the questions we need to ask ourselves. How many bananas in the tailpipe are we gonna keep falling for till we sit back and realize ain't nobody coming to save you, ain't nobody coming to save me. The only thing that is gonna save us is if we save us from ourselves. And that's it. And that's gonna take putting your ego aside, your beliefs aside, your lies aside, your job, your money, and your valued possessions that you think you have to hold on to and be able to keep that stature. I'm certainly not talking to anyone who would be watching this who is not in that mode, trying to speak of those who would be. And to get people to just realize that the only thing you came here to do is stop this from happening. And the only way you could have done it is to learn to love yourself, learn to love life and freedom, and then have it attempted to be stripped from you and see if you love it enough to save it, because that's what's been going on here. And you knew that coming in. Most of us have just forgotten. And it takes nothing but a small spark and a small fire to grow into a huge one. And as I said last time, this really big shoe is only getting started. And we are the cast of this really big shoe.
Really big shoe. No, I can do it better.
Really big shoe. Really big.
That's it.
It's not something to be observed. It's something to partake in. So let's partake in it and change this motherfucker back to what it's supposed to be before it's too late. Love you guys. Get learning, get speaking.